you, sir. I thank the honourable member for that question. The simple answer, sir, is yes. We utilize the WHO guideline. There is actually a guidance document. It's called the International Guideline for Certification and Classification of COVID-19 Deaths. And honourable speaker, what usually happens is every person who passes away, when they're tested and that comes out as positive, for those that we do not know yet that are positive, they are then discussed. This is discussed between the physicians, the doctors, the specialists from the certain areas, including bringing out the medical records. And again, bringing to the fore the importance of actually making sure that we validate names, because in some instances, there have been members of the public, our families, that have been waiting for a few days until the certification has been carried through, because we're waiting for the folders to be actually ascertained that this is exactly the person that had passed away. So they then sit down with a medical history that's at present, they discuss the history, and then they make the decision whether the person died from COVID or died with COVID. And as you are aware, there may be some who had myocardial infarction, or they had high blood pressure, and they also had ischemic heart disease or stroke, and they died from this. It was important to actually ascertain them. So that's why our classification system had the two in place. But this is in keeping with what WHO had put out in its guidance, that we need to ensure that we document those who died with COVID and those who died from COVID.